In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
As we gather together, let us remember God's tremendous love for us as we hear in our first reading in our gospel. And as we go through difficult days, we know that God is here with us to heal us. If we only touch the hem of his garment, and he raises us to new life. Let us call to mind our sins and pray for God's mercy. Lord Jesus, you heal the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgave sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you gave yourself to heal us and bring us strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, our refuge in trials, our strength in sickness, our comfort in sorrow, spare your people, we pray, that though rightly chastised by affliction, we may find relief at last through your loving mercy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Hosea. Thus says the Lord, I will allure her. I will lead her into the desert and speak to her heart. She will respond there as in the days of her youth, when she came up from the land of Egypt. On that day, says the Lord, she shall call me my husband, and never again my Baal. I will espouse you to me forever. I will espouse you in right and in justice, in love and in mercy. I will espouse you in fidelity, and you shall know the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
Every day will I bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and highly to be praised. His greatness is unsearchable.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
Generation after generation praises your works and proclaims your might. They speak of the splendor of your glorious majesty and tell of your wondrous works.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
They discourse of the power of your terrible deeds and declare your greatness. They publish the fame of your abundant goodness and joyfully sing of your justice.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
While Jesus was speaking, an official came forward, knelt down before him, and said, "My daughter has just died. Come, lay your hand on her, and she will live." Jesus rose and followed him, and so did his disciples. A woman suffering hemorrhages for 12 years came up behind him and touched the tassel of his cloak. She said to herself, "If I only touch his cloak, I shall be cured." Jesus turned around and saw her and said, "Courage, daughter, your faith has saved you." And from that hour, the woman was cured. When Jesus arrived at the official's house and saw the flute players and the crowd who were making a commotion, he said, "Go away. The girl is not dead, but sleeping." And they ridiculed him. When the crowd was put out, he came and took her by the hand, and the little girl rose. And the news of this spread throughout all the land. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us continue our prayer to the Lord.
For our church, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace throughout the world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the unity of all who believe in Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, especially those on our prayer list, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our personal intentions, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we ask this of you, merciful Father, in the name of your crucified and risen Son, Jesus. The unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer. Fruit of the fields and work of human hands, it will become the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord, wash me of my iniquities and cleanse me of my sins. Pray, my sisters and my brothers in baptism, that the offering we bring to this holy altar might become the sacrifice which is acceptable to God, our Father Almighty.
May the Lord
accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church. Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care, we may never lose what we have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for the sinners, and he became neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all of your daughters and sons. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name, and sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walks with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, he broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you are seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis our Pope, Curtis our Bishop, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our sisters and brothers. Inspire us in words and in action to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her all-good and holy husband Joseph, the blessed apostles Peter and Paul, the martyrs, especially the deacon martyr Lawrence, Saint Anthony our patron, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other this peace of Christ.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of our world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should come under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. We pray, O Lord, that in receiving your sacrament, we may experience help in mind and body, so that kept safe in both, we may glory in the fullness of heavenly healing, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Through the prayers of the Holy Mother of God, together with all the saints, especially our patron, Saint Anthony, may the Lord bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace. Thanks be to God. Have a blessed day. Keep safe and keep keep healthy.